We gathered together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
May dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the secret mysteries. With humble heart, together we say, I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful and keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. Shepherd your people with your staff, the flock of your inheritance that dwells apart in a woodland in the midst of Carmel. Let them feed in Bashan and Gilead as in the days of old, as in the days when you came from the land of Egypt. Show us wonderful signs. Who is there like you, the God who removes guilt and pardons sin for the remnant of his inheritance, who does not persist in anger forever, but delights rather in clemency, and will again have compassion on us, treading underfoot our guilt? You will cast into the depths of the sea all our sins. You will show faithfulness to Jacob and grace to Abraham, as you have sworn to our fathers from days of old. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, show us your mercy and love.
Lord, show us your mercy and love.
You have favored, O Lord, your land. You have brought back the captives of Jacob. You have forgiven the guilt of your people. You have covered all their sins. You have withdrawn all your wrath. You have revoked your burning anger.
Lord, show us your mercy and love.
Restore us, O God, our Savior, and abandon your displeasure against us. Will you be ever angry with us, prolonging your anger to all generations?
Lord, show us your mercy and love.
Will you not instead give us life, and shall not your people rejoice in you? Show us, O Lord, your kindness, and grant us your salvation.
Lord, show us your mercy and love. Please stand.
Oh,
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
While Jesus was speaking to the crowds, his mother and his brothers appeared outside, wishing to speak with him. Someone told him, "Your mother and your brothers are standing outside, asking to speak with you." But he said in reply to the one who told him, "Who is my mother? Who are my brothers?" And stretching out his hand toward his disciples, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers, for whoever does the will of the Heavenly Father is my brother and sister and mother." May dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. As we continue our journey on the 16th week in Ordinary Time, we come together always in the sanctuary, the altar of God, to express our gratitude and having a grateful heart to our loving God, to our loving Father, who is the author of everything that we have. And most especially, we're thankful for Him for giving us our family. May pamilya po tayo. Biniyaan po tayo ng pamilya ng Panginoon. And we Filipinos, my dear brothers and sisters, as the world knows, we are known for family-oriented with bonded family structures, where respect for parents and elders are indispensable virtue, strongly shows our value of having the fourth commandment, honor your father and mother. Expressly to children and their relationship to their father and mother. Because this relationship, my dear brothers and sisters, is the most universal. Ito ang makatotohanan at pangkalahatang relasyon na taglay natin sa ating pang-araw-araw na buhay. Having our gospel passage today, my dear brothers and sisters, the word of Jesus might surprise us. Disowning his family, was really he ignoring or disregarding his family members? My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus wanted to emphasize the priority of his mission above everything else. God's will should be the supreme rule of every Christian's life. That's why Jesus' action today in our gospel, stretching out his hand towards his disciple, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers, for whoever does the will of my Heavenly Father is my brother and sister and mother." Jesus simply seized the moment to teach his listeners a very important lesson about God's family or brothers and sisters to one another. Thus, my dear brothers and sisters, belonging to God's family is measured only by faith and obedience to God's will. And we have our own families. We have our own respective families, my dear brothers and sisters. and where we can experience God's love through our parents, siblings, and relatives. And living within that love is also a real manifestation of doing God's love. It is clear that for Jesus, love expressed by the union of His wills. In reality, or in our ordinariness of our life, mother, brothers, and sisters, our relationship with Jesus and the Father is expressed in obedience. Ito'y makikita sa ating pagsunod sa kalooban ng ating Panginoon, sa kalooban ng Diyos na dapat nating gawin araw-araw. And of course, as we journey, as we live every day, we are in relationship, my dear brothers and sisters. Always remember this. We are in relationship with God every day. Nasa relasyon po tayo araw-araw. Kumbaga, araw-araw, tayong lahat ay nabubuhay na may relasyon sa Panginoon. Saano po natin ito may papakita na tayo ay nakikipagrelasyon sa ating Panginoon? We have our family right now. We have our family structure in our life every day. That's why hindi po tayo nahulog galing sa langit, direkta, na bilang mga anak ng Diyos, pinadaan tayo sa ating mga magulang sa isang tahanan. That's the way God revealed His life to us. Having family structure. So therefore, mother, brothers, and sisters, embracing that family structure, dyan po natin may papakita ang pagmamahal at pagsunod natin sa Panginoon. That's why we live in the fourth commandment, honor your father and mother. Kaya po, kailangan nating sundin ang ating mga magulang, ang mga nakakatanda sa atin. Dahil sigurado po ako, wala pong magulang na nais mapahamak o mahirapan ang kanyang anak. Ganon din ang kaisipan ng ating Panginoon. The Father, our Father, wants us to have a good life every day. Very good life every day. Ganon din ang kaisipan ng mga magulang sa kanyang mga anak. Kaya kailangan natin sundin ito sa ating buhay pang-araw-araw. That's why the Lord telling us today, do the will of the Father. That is the expression who belongs to God's family. Tayong lahat ay iisa sa kanyang pamilya sa pagsunod sa kalooban ng Diyos. Ibig sabihin, mga minamahal na kapatid, kung ano ang ating relasyon sa ating mga magulang, sa ating pamilya, ganun din nakatuon o nakadirekta ang ating relasyon sa ating Panginoon. Kaya pagsuway sa mga magulang, pag hindi pagsunod, ay isang pagkakamali na uuwi sa pagkakasala. That's why we are reminded today, we are in relationship always with God, every day, through our family structure that we have. That's why that God's love moving around in our family. The instrument of God's love through our parents, through our home, that is the manifestation of God's love, and God's love expresses of doing our will or doing His will by our obedient children of God. And this is our prayer today, my dear brothers and sisters, hoping that we are always in the virtue of obedience or obedience in our life. Huwag po natin kakalimutan, huwag matigas ang ulo. Sumunod palagi sa kabutihan. Iyan ang nais ng Diyos para sa atin. Amen.
Please stand.
My dear brothers and sisters, gathered together as community, let us ask God our Father for our needs. And every petition we say, Father, in the name of Jesus, bless us.
Father, in the name of Jesus, bless us.
That the church may become a true family, faithful to the will of the Father and to the teachings of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, in the name of Jesus, bless us.
That government leaders may not enact laws or initiate programs contrary to our faith and morals. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, in the name of Jesus, bless us.
That families may become true brothers and sisters by their love for one another as willed by Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, in the name of Jesus, bless us.
That we may show concern for those suffering in any form, that we may lighten their burdens and help them to keep trusting in God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, in the name of Jesus, bless us.
That the faithful departed may come to their everlasting home, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, in the name of Jesus, bless us.
In the silence of our hearts, let us now pray for our personal intentions. Loving Father, help us to become your faithful children who are obedient to your holy will. Grant this to Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all grace, the goodness you have received, the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of the human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all grace, the goodness you have received. The wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of the human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought the completion buried offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving itself be a gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation, through Christ our Lord. And so, in the company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna
in the highest.
Blessed
is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which you poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life in the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have made us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by taking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, the church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of their resurrection and who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that to the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints you have pleased throughout the ages, we merit to be coerced to eternal life, and I praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and firm by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
My dear brothers and sisters, this is Jesus, the very source of our life. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed is called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word,
and my soul shall be healed.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and let those who have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a while.
Good morning. Before Father Jock gives the final blessing, I would like to take this opportunity to thank him because this will be his final mass here at the cathedral before he goes to Taiwan to be a missionary. Father Jock has been serving the cathedral since Monsignor Nestor Serbo. So I will be the third rector that he has served in the past 15 years, maybe around that time. So, Father Job, the community of the Manila Cathedral would wish to thank you for your generosity and for making yourself available on call whenever we need a priest. And we assure you of our prayers that your new post in Taiwan will be full of grace and that you will be able to do the mission assigned to you by the Lord. So we assure you of our prayers and we thank Father Job for his service. Palakpakan po natin sila. I hope your flight will not be canceled because of the bad weather. And I think tomorrow is your flight, no? Tomorrow. So he will be leaving together with a companion tomorrow for Taiwan. The second is, let us also pray for Father Biel and other priests who are having their retreat beginning last night. it's a time for them to rest a while with the Lord. So let us also pray for Father Biel and the priests who are having their annual retreat in Alfonso, Cavite. And finally, let us pray for our brothers and sisters who are suffering because of this bad weather. We are still lucky here in Metro Manila, but there are places in the country that has been submerged, you know, in water and now experiencing high tide, strong wind, heavy rain. Let us pray for their safety. And you, as you go to your places, you go back home, or you go to the office, please take care. So maraming salamat po.
Please stand.
To Manila Cathedral Community, to Monsignor Rolly and Father Biel, maraming salamat po sa pagpapatuloy niyo din po sa akin dito sa cathedral to exercise my ministry as a priest. I'm so very happy and very glad to have having my present here, no po, celebrating with daily mass and of course weddings. Maraming salamat po, Monsi and Father Biel, and the Manila Cathedral Community and all of you who are always present in our celebration. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God of all consolation order your days in His peace and grant you the gifts of His blessing.
Amen.
May He free you always from every distress and confirm your hearts in His love.
Amen.
So that on this life's journey, you may be effective in good works, rich in the gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and become populate to eternal life.
Amen.
And Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here today, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Pusong dalisay dakila.